Hey everyone, in this video we are going to discuss difference between array and ArrayList. Alright, the very first difference is arrays are static in nature. It means that arrays are a fixed length data structure. You cannot change their size once they are created, whereas ArrayList is a dynamic in nature. Its size is automatically increased if you add elements beyond its capacity. So look at here the code snippet. This is how we create an array object in Java. In Java, our arrays are objects and we can use a new operator to create an object. And here we specify size while creating an array. And once the array is created, its length is fixed. We cannot change its size once it is created. All right, and this is how we create object of ArrayList. ArrayList internally uses arrays. And sometimes ArrayList is called a dynamic array or resizable array because it automatically resizes itself if you try to add elements beyond its capacity. By default, its capacity is 10. As you add elements beyond its capacity, then ArrayList will, resizes. Alright, so remember these points. Next difference is arrays can hold both primitives as well as objects, whereas arrays can hold only objects. Okay, array can hold primitive types such as integer, float, double, long, etc. It also holds objects, whereas array can hold only objects. And if you try to insert primitive data into ArrayList, data is automatically boxed into corresponding wrapper class. For example, look at here, array can hold integer and string objects. Okay, and ArrayList only holds objects, so integer is a class and string is also class. Okay, ArrayList cannot hold primitive types such as int, double, float, long, etc. We have to use wrapper classes. Like instead of primitive type int, we can use a corresponding wrapper class integer. Okay, and if you try to insert primitive data here, I'm inserting 10 20. Okay, if you try to insert primitive data into an array list it is automatically boxed into corresponding wrapper class, that is integer. Okay, this is automatically done by the compiler. All right, just remember, array can hold primitive types as well as objects, whereas ArrayList holds only objects. Okay, so next difference is arrays can be iterated only through for loop or for each loop, whereas ArrayList provides a iterator to iterate through other elements. Alright, so we can iterate over arrays using normal for loop or for each enhanced loop, whereas in case of ArrayList, ArrayList provides iterators to iterate over their elements. For example, so here we can use a for loop, okay, to iterate over an array. And here what I will do, I will put this out and I will just access the elements like this. And in case of array, we can also use for each loop like this. And here I will provide a sysout to just print the elements of an array. Okay, so we iterate over an array using normal for loop or for each loop. And in case of ArrayList, ArrayList provides an iterator, and we can use iterator to iterate over elements. For example, like this, ArrayList provides an iterator method which returns an iterator object. And now we can use a while loop to iterate over iterator, and here we just print an integer. Okay, so this is how we iterate over ArrayList using iterator. So let me run the program and let us see the output. So look at here, this prints this normal for loop, and this enhanced for loop prints these values. Even we can also use a for loop and enhanced for loop to iterate over ArrayList, and we can also use a for each method with lambda expressions to iterate over ArrayList. For example, in Java 8, lambda expressions are introduced, as well as for each method is introduced, for example. So look at here in Java 8, for each method is introduced and lambda expression. So we can use for each method with lambda expression to iterate over array list like this. Alright, let us see the next difference. The size of an array is checked using length attribute, whereas the size of an array list can be checked using size method. For example, look at the code snippet here. This is an integer array with some elements, and here we are using length attribute to find the length of an array. And here in case of array list, we are using size method to check the size of an array list. Alright, just remember, array provides a length attribute to find the length of an array, and array list provides a size method to get a size of an array. Alright, good. Let's run this program and look at here the output. Let us see the next difference. Array gives constant type performance for both add and get operations, whereas ArrayList also gives a constant type performance for both add and get operations, provided adding an element does not trigger resize. It means that both array and ArrayList gives a constant time performance for both add and get operations. But in case of ArrayList, if adding an element requires resizing up an ArrayList, then it gets slightly slower, as it involves creating a new array in the background and copying all elements from an old array to new array. Okay. Next difference is, array does not support generics, whereas ArrayList supports generics. Okay. For example, look at here the code snippet. Array does not support generics, but ArrayList supports generics. And look at here. Here we are using generic ArrayList. Here it means that ArrayList provides a type safety and array does not provide a type safety. Okay, remember, just array does not support generics, but ArrayList supports generics. Okay, great. As I mentioned, arrays are not type safe, whereas ArrayList are type safe, because ArrayList are using generics. We can provide a type by using generics in case of ArrayList. Arrays can be multi-dimensional, but ArrayList cannot be a multi-dimensional. Okay. Elements are added using assignment operator in array, whereas elements are added using add method in ArrayList. For example, so look at here, we can add a element to an array like this. I want to add array element to an index 3. For example, I'm going to add element 5 to the index of 3 of an array like this. We are using assignment operator to add an element to an array, and in case of array list, we are using add method to add an element to an array list. Okay, so these are the few differences between array and array list. Let me summarize what we have discussed so far. Arrays are static in nature. Arrays are fixed length data structures. You can't change their size once they are created. Whereas ArrayList is dynamic in nature. Its size is automatically increased if you add elements beyond its capacity. Alright, arrays can hold both primitives as well as objects, whereas ArrayList can hold only objects. Okay, arrays can be iterated through for loop or for each loop, whereas ArrayList provides iterators to iterate over elements. Okay, the size of an array is checked using length attribute, whereas the size of the array list can be checked using size method. Alright, array gives constant type performance for both add and get operations, whereas array list also gives a constant type performance for both add and get operations, provided adding an element does not trigger resize. Arrays don't support generics, whereas array list support generics. Arrays are not type safe, whereas ArrayList are type safe. Arrays can be multidimensional, whereas ArrayList can't be multidimensional. Elements are added using assignment operator in array, whereas elements are added using add method in ArrayList. Alright, I hope you found this video tutorial useful. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Whenever I will publish such videos, you will get notified. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.